The Memphis Grizzlies have seen a lot of first in the little over a decade and a half that they've called Tennessee home. They've clawed their way up from one of the worst teams in the league to one of the best and have the battle scars to prove it. But even more notable than the accomplishments cast upon the walls of the FedEx Forum, this team catalyzed a community into action as well as admiration. The Grizzlies are much like the families that form this great city. They aren't immune to dirt, drama, or being down, and they're bound to see good seasons and bad. But the point is, they'll see them all the same and won't let it set them back. This team may have found their home at the Forum, but they live and breathe because of the blood pumped by the heart that is Memphis. And that's something we can all believe in.
When you work for the organization, I think everybody that works for our organization feels a burden beyond just providing an entertainment option, you know, which is what basketball is in most cities. But here, being the only professional sports team and being so tied into the city's self-image and the recent success and growth of the city, I just feel an extra special responsibility that we carry more than just, hey, have fun tonight.
You'll see Mike Conley, you know, on a public golf course.
Yeah.
You know, you'll see Tony Allen dropping his kids off at school.
Yeah.
And I think people in this community can relate to that because they're not just basketball players, they're citizens of this community as well. They don't go and run and hide and live off in some enclaves outside of town. They're right within the fabric of this city. You can find yourself in the players on the court. I mean, this is a team full of perfect imperfections. You know what I mean? It's a team that, as Jason said, you know, you're not gonna find, you know, the most fit looking guy. You're not gonna find the tallest guy, the prettiest jump shot. You're not gonna find the guy that dunks it, you know, and win dunks contest. But they're gonna get out there and fight. They're gonna get out there, dive on the floor. It's not about dunks, it's about dives more so than anything else. And that, you know, sort of underscores the mentality of this city.
Very famous moment in this team's history where they had these growl towels, they call them, that said Believe Memphis, which was a slogan for a long time, Believe Memphis. And the team was behind in a playoff game, and almost spontaneously, everyone held these towels up in a sort of a wall of Believe Memphis. And at that moment, it wasn't just, I believe we can come back and win. It was really about, I believe in the potential of this river town that not everybody believes in. And it really, to me, that's what this team has done. It has given belief to a city that was in need of things to grab onto.